So here we are at the tomb of Sir Christopher Wren, brilliant designer of St. Paul's Cathedral and great hero of architecture. It only took him 35 years to complete this building. Now, we must move on. Do please follow me.
Well, I never. That young lady suggested that it was easy to design this cathedral. Preposterous. I must set the record straight. This year marks 300 years since I was alive. Take a look at my tomb to see how we counted all those years ago. These are Roman numerals. You might recognize these. They say the year 1723, 1723. How we count might have changed. And the tools we have are much improved. But the principle of good design remains the same. I wanted this cathedral to be strong, beautiful, and useful. Let's explore this magnificent place and discover how this building came into being. Let's start with, how does one start to build a building of this magnitude? It all began with a plan. After the Great Fire of London of 1666, which destroyed Old St. Paul's Cathedral, I was tasked with designing a new cathedral for London to restore hope. I wanted something that would stand out, something that would inspire awe and wonder. But what shape would I choose? The old St. Paul's had a great spire, but I decided to construct a dome. The king, the Lord Mayor and Bishop, they weren't happy with this choice. Despite creating an extraordinary model, 3D, that's what this is. So large that King Charles II, yes, the second, could sit inside it. The design was not to be. And finally, the warrant design was drawn up. A shape pleasing to all parties, part dome and part spire, signed by the crown. However, as they say, always read the fine print. The contract states that I could make some changes, rather ornamental than essential. So I did, and here we are with our incredible domed cathedral. Now the plans were laid, it was time to decide what materials I used to construct such a thing. And who might help me build this design? This all in a time before electricity, cranes, or technology. Now, don't look down. We're at the viewing platform. From here, you can see all the detail. See the flowers, fruit, and geometric shapes. From this huge structure to be strong yet beautiful, what materials do you think I used and why? Stone was chosen. Portland stone, to be precise. Hard enough to provide strength, and soft enough to be carved and made into fine art. Look around the space. What other materials do you see? Why are they chosen? Did you see the glass windows? Chosen to let in light through its transparency. Did you find any more? Within the stone you can find many geometric shapes. Take a look and see how many you can name. To work with all these different materials, we had a skilled team from stonemasons to carpenters. One of our more unusual design choices you'll find outside. The gilded pineapples on the tower were cast in iron by Jane Brewer. So welcome to St. Paul's Cathedral, my masterpiece. Come a little closer, shall we? They only open these doors for members of royalty, guests of the dean and chapter, and very important people. I'm a very important person, and so are you. Come on, what are we waiting for? Just look up and take it all in. The dome was my masterpiece. Standing at 111 meters tall, it can be seen from all corners of the city. But do you think the units we measured in have changed over the years? Do you? Well, what do you think the measured height is 300 years ago? Would you like a clue? Now think about your height. That's right. Feet and inches. 111 meters equals to 365 feet. Do you notice something special about that particular number? That's right. It's how many days there are in a year. Every year? What about that special year with one more day? That's right, a leap year. I wasn't going to forget about that, you know. I added a little extra just to make it right. Now, this may look like one dome, but it is in fact three in one. We have the dome we can see from the inside, the outer dome that you can see from the outside, and inside that, there is a cone. Now, the inner dome is made of brick. The inner cone is made of brick, but the outer dome is made of wood and covered in lead. And all in all, they weigh 65,000 tons. Did I tell you that the weight of my three domes is 65,000 tons? Did I? But did I tell you that this was the first domed building ever built in this country? It had never been done before. Now, I'm sure you are wondering, how does one get up there to add the decoration? A time before cranes, we used a marvelous piece of equipment called a pulley. That was a basket or a platform that could be hoisted up via a rope and wheel and held in place to complete the work. Another way to get up there, of course, is by building some stairs. Let's go and take a look at some of the most impressive stairs you will ever have seen. The 88 steps form a double spiral. The tower was made first, then each step was inserted into the wall by only approximately 10 centimeters. Each step is supported by the step below, and only by the tiniest amount. As you can see, this gives the impression that the staircase is floating. What do you think is holding this structure in place? Something that is pulling down. That's right. Gravity holds this structure together. This internal cylinder sits outside an external cuboid tower. You might recognize these stairs as they're so special and unique. They feature in lots of films, including Harry Potter and Paddington 2, to name but a few. Thank you for joining me on this spectacular tour of St. Paul's Cathedral. I really hope that one day you can visit for yourself and be inspired by the architecture, beauty, and peace found inside this wonderful building.